Assalamu alaikum. Today on the last day of our Quranic stories, we shall learn the virtues from Hadrat Musa's life. In Islam, Musa or Moses is loved and respected. He's both a prophet and a messenger. God mentions him more than 120 times, and his story ranges across several chapters. It is the longest and most detailed story of a prophet in the Quran and is discussed in elaborate detail. Prophet Moses' story contains many lessons for mankind. Allah says that the account of Moses and Pharaoh in Quran is the truth. It is a story of political intrigue and of oppression that knew no bounds. There are lessons for mankind throughout the story of Moses, which are not only learned after his prophethood. Rather, they found even when he was a newborn. His righteous mother's behavior gives us numerous lessons that are relevant even today. Prophet Musa alayhi salam was born into one of the most political charged times in history. He was born when the Pharaoh of Egypt was a dominant power figure in the land. He was so incredibly powerful that he referred to himself as a god. And nobody was inclined or able to dispute this. He said, "I'm your Lord, Most High." The king had a dream that an Israeli baby shall be born and grow to ruin his kingdom. Thus, it decided that all babies born to Israelites will be killed at birth. When Prophet Moses was born, his parents' heart must have been constricted with joy and fear simultaneously. What were they to do now? How would they conceal a newborn baby? Prophet Moses' mother was a righteous woman, pious and God-fearing. Therefore, in her hour of need, she turned to Allah and he inspired her next actions. Allah reassured his mother in the magnificent verse where he issued two commands, two prohibitions, and two promises. And we inspired to the mother of Moses, suckle him. And when you fear for him, cast him into the river and do not fear and do not grieve. Indeed, we'll return him to you and we'll make him one of the messengers. Surah Al-Qasas, verse number 7. Prophet Moses' mother had just spent the last months concealing her pregnancy for fear that her child will be put to death. And now, against her natural maternal instincts, she obeyed the command with absolute trust and reliance on Allah. She casted the baby in the river on a basket, which was followed by his sister. It was not a gentle stream, but the Nile River, a huge, powerful river with a strong current.
Her initial reaction must have been that such an action would be condemning him to certain death.
But the amount of steadfastness in the faith towards the Almighty, Musa's mother had it surprising. What is it like to give your child up? Well, despite Allah not commanding us with such drastic measures, we continue to doubt his wisdom and his promises. We place our perceived interest before his pleasure, not realizing that our interest is only in his obedience. So we neglect our prayers, assuming that our time is being saved. We neglect our fast, assuming that we're less productive at work because of it. We neglect the zakah and inheritance, thinking that our wealth will stay with us, all the while being deceived by the false promises of the shaytan, the devil,
that only lead to destruction in this life as well as in hereafter.
Now, what were the chances a newborn baby survives in a weaved basket tossed around by the current of a flowing river? But Allah saved Prophet Moses from drowning. It has been narrated that as the baby's basket touched the water, the raging current became calm and gentle, sweeping the basket silently downstream. The basket with its precious cargo courses down the Nile River, passing houses, boats, and people unnoticed until it stopped at Pharaoh's place. Prophet Moses' sister watches in fear as someone from Pharaoh's household removed the basket from the river. Moses was cast into the river to escape certain death, and now his resting place is the palace of Pharaoh. This is surely too much for a mother to bear. However, events about to unfold will demonstrate that the promise of God is true. Baby Moses was taken to the wife of Pharaoh, Hadrat Asiya. Hadrat Asiya, in contrast to her arrogant, proud husband, was a righteous, merciful woman. God opened her heart and Bibi Asiya looked down up on the beautiful baby and fell in love with him straight away. The royal couple were unable to conceive a child and this tiny baby awakened her maternal instincts. Bibi Asiya clutched him to her chest and asked her husband to accept the child into family. Only Allah knew what he had installed for him and his future. Possibly against his better judgment, Pharaoh accepted the child who was part of God's plan to bring down the royal house. Far from abandoning him, God set Prophet Moses up as a royal son of Egypt. He provided him with the strongest human support in the land. Ossia and Pharaoh now had a son, who was not protected by the very person who had sought to kill him. The lesson we can derive from this is that sometimes when hardship comes to us, we may be inclined to say, "Why me?" But the truth is, we do not know the benefits Allah has put into this hardship. If we only handle it correctly by relying on Allah and turning to Him for relief. Prophet Musa's mother turned to Allah in difficult times and followed His command, trusting Him completely, and her faith was rewarded. Let's see how. Baby Musa was adopted, but it was not long when he began to cry for milk. And so ladies were born to him to feed him. However, he did not take milk from any of them. His sister, who had been watching this the whole time, approached Bibi Asia and said that she knew a lady whom the baby may accept the milk from. She also persuaded her that she'll be a good woman to help bring him up. Bibi Asia asked her to bring this lady to the kingdom. This lady was Prophet Musa's mother. Mother and daughter lost no time returning to the palace. When Moses was handed to his real mother, he settled immediately and began to suckle. As per the narration, the household, including Pharaoh himself, was astonished. Pharaoh asked the woman who she was, and she replied, "I'm a woman of sweet milk and sweet smell, and no child refuses me." Pharaoh accepted this answer, and thus Moses was returned to the arms of his mother and raised in the palace as a prince of Egypt, and was treated like royalty until he was a strong young man. As Allah says in Surah Al-Qas, verse number 13, "So we restored him to his mother, that she might be content and not grieve, and that she would know that the promise of Allah is true." But most of the people do not know. We continue to question our Creator, forgetting that He's the one who created us. We doubt Allah's mercy, do not trust Him, then complain about the problems we have in our lives. But only if we knew that having faith with pure intentions could bring us. As says in Quran, "Khayril makirin," indeed Allah is the best of planners. The Pharaoh had planned to kill all the newborn Israelites. Little did he know that he would be overthrown by the baby he would adopt. Later, when Musa grew up, he attained prophethood as Allah promised his mother. He saved all the Israelites from the tyrant Pharaoh through God's command, and the king finally died. Quran is a book of guidance for all of humankind. It is not a history book. However, it does contain historical information. Allah asks us to reflect and contemplate on the stories of the prophets in order that we may learn from their trials. These incidents mentioned in the sacred word are for us to learn and absorb the direction to a righteous life. So brothers and sisters, these were the 8 stories from the Holy Quran. Inshallah, from tomorrow, for 12 days till the end of Ramadan, we shall revise the lessons from the lives of Al-A'imma al-Athna Ashar, from Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib to Imam al-Mahdi, ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif. Stay tuned. Until then, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.